Coming up, Azure Stack, which for the first time gives you Microsoft Azure Services to run your data center like a service provider. We show you how you can leverage the operational and resource management model of Azure for your data center on-premises, and explore how this hybrid approach gives you the flexibility to deploy apps and resources where and when you need them. I'm joined by Jeffrey Snover, who's been instrumental on the work with Azure Stack. Jeffrey, welcome.
Yeah, great to be back here on Mechanics.
So what's the significance of what we're doing here?
Yeah, so simply put, what we're doing is taking the power of Azure and making it available in your data centers.
What are we looking to solve for?
Yeah, so developers need to respond very quickly to business needs. So often what they're doing is they're developing these applications in the public cloud without IT involvement. This allows them to go very, very fast. But then IT has to come in and clean things up for data protection, compliance, security.
So what you're saying is that we need an environment where IT has control and they can be involved, but it gives developers the flexibility of what they need.
Yeah, that's exactly it. That's what Azure Stack is. Azure Stack is the first product in a new category. That is the hybrid cloud platform. This product allows IT to deliver their data center resources with a cloud service delivery model. Okay, so basically you now run your on-premises data center in the same way we run Azure and offer the same services, literally the same services, because it's exactly the same code. And because it's the real thing, you can decide where you want to deploy your applications, either on-prem via Azure Stack, in the Azure public cloud, or with trusted hosters.
So how does it work?
Okay, well, let's show you some code. All right. So this is the Azure portal. Behold its beauty. This is connected to the public cloud, see Microsoft Azure. And here I click new, and this shows me all the resources available to me in Azure. Okay, I'll now click on compute, and it's gonna show me all the compute resources. So I'm gonna pick Windows Server 2012 R2, and this is where if I want to go create the VM, I'd create it. Now compare that experience against Azure Stack. So Azure Stack, this is a portal focused in on an Azure Stack running in a data center. Notice the only difference between it and the other is the fact that at the top it says Microsoft Azure Stack. So now when I click new, I see a set of resources. We have the core resources to start, and then that will grow over time. I click on compute. I've got Windows Server 2012 R2, and I click through, and this is how I would create a VM. So it's the same experience across the two portals.
Great. So it seems incredibly consistent from a UI perspective, but how does this change from an IT administrative perspective?
Yeah, so Azure Stack puts you as an IT pro at the center of your business's adoption of the cloud. It allows you to empower your developers to do their best work while ensuring that they comply to the industry best practices. Specifically, they're able to offer Azure services as a cloud service delivery model. That allows them access to the services they need to develop their applications quickly and with great agility, while ensuring that they do so with IT controls.
So it gets done right the first time and there's less cleanup.
Yeah, exactly. You don't have to go clean things up afterwards.
So should we take a look?
Yeah, let's do that. Okay, so here again, we go to the Azure Stack. As an IT pro, I go to the resource providers. These are the things that I'm providing to my developers and to my tenants. And you see, these are the services that I'm offering them. I'll click on storage provider, and this gives me an overall view of the storage of the system. I click on that, and what I get is an overview of all the storage. Okay, so it's showing me the capacity, whether I have active faults, lots of details like total requests in the past day, the availability, so I know how my service is being delivered to my users. And then if I want to, I can drill into specific things like the blob service or the table service. All those details are available to me right here. So I am delivering and running the Azure services and delivering that to my developers.
So how do we make storage, as an example, and other resources available to our tenants or developers?
So that's where things really change. The role of the IT now, you focus more on being a consultant, being an architect, etc., by defining these as by defining plans and offers. So plan is where you make various resources available to different groups of people. So for instance, the needs of a developer team, you know, dev test team, are different than the needs of a production team. So what you can do is you can define a plan for them and put the proper IT controls in them. And then this becomes the contract between the IT pros and the developers.
So how do we create one of those plans?
Let's show you. Okay, so here we're going to go create a plan. This is my view as an IT pro. I come to the Microsoft Azure Stack. I click on plans. You see I've already got a couple, but I'll add a new one here for SharePoint developers. Okay, so this is for SharePoint developers. So we're going to call the plan development. Now I pick what services I'm going to offer. I'm going to give them the storage, compute, and networking, give them access to all that. And now I have the opportunity to go in and configure quotas, okay? So we don't want them consuming all the quotas. But for networking, we're going to come here. You see I have lots of control. And what I'm going to do is I'm going to give them unlimited ingress and egress for networking. I'm very generous.
Yes.
But when it comes to storage, I don't want them consuming all the storage. So I'm going to assign a storage quota of 500 gigabytes maximum and 20 storage accounts. Same thing with compute. I don't want my developers consuming all the CPUs and screwing up the production. So what I do is I put up a quota here. And instead of unlimited number of virtual machines, I'm going to give them access to 10. Okay, so I click OK. Okay again. And now I create this plan. Okay, you see it pop up here on my desktop. And when I drill into that plan, it's essentially in edit mode. And so now what I want to do is to go ahead and make it public. So I click plan settings. And you see it's currently private. I click on public. And this makes it available for being incorporated into various offers and used by tenants.
Mm-hmm. So lots of new things to learn there. It looks really powerful, but actually it's quite streamlined and easy to use at the same time. But
yeah, it is.
We've got the plan. We've got the offer. How do we consume the offer now as a developer?
Great. So now tenants will consume this, whether they're IT pros or developers. Let me show you Portal from their perspective. And I've changed the colors to show that I've changed personas. So notice the left hand's a little bit different. I'm going to go say get a subscription. I'm going to select an offer. Here it shows me the offers. I'm a SharePoint developer, so I'm going to pick the SharePoint developer offer.
And this is you subscribing to that offer.
Exactly. I select that. That was successful. I look at the subscriptions, my SharePoint developer subscription. And this gives me the details of that subscription. Now, all the resources that were created will be under the subscription and will be under the controls set by the IT pro.
So now we have our environment accessible through the offer. How do our SharePoint developers access that?
Great. Let's go into the portal and show you how. To define applications, we have the Azure Resource Manager templates. The templates build out a reference architecture of the infrastructure components required to run the application. These can then be deployed within the boundaries of the plan that you set up. There's a growing set of popular templates available on GitHub. Here's the URL to get to that. So let's take a look at a template for deploying SharePoint. This is the template for deploying SharePoint. Notice an instance of this template will create a virtual network, 3 storage accounts, 2 external load balancers, and then 3 VMs configured different ways. This is the JSON file that defines the details of the template, defines the resources and the properties available. You can deploy the template in a number of ways. You can deploy it from the portal, through Visual Studio, or through PowerShell.
So once that's deployed, what does that look like?
Great. So here it is. I've deployed that using PowerShell. I now click on the SharePoint site. And this is my resource group. And here you see my 3 VMs, the 2 network load balancers, and the virtual NICs. So these are all the components necessary to run SharePoint. And again, they're running within the controls that the IT pros set up.
Great. So how is Azure Stack delivered?
You'll run this on a single machine. We recommend 128 gigabytes of RAM, 12 cores, 4 hard drives for storage, 1 for the OS. And this is just the beginning. We're working with a number of the hardware vendors to define reference architectures to run Azure Stack great.
That sounds like quite a beefy configuration, but I guess it makes sense if you're running the same services that we run in our worldwide data centers.
Exactly correct.
So what can we do today to get started?
So just try out the proof of concept. Download the bits, get a hold of our deployment guide, and give us some feedback.
And you can also check out the recent show on the Azure Resource Manager templates to learn more about the unified development and operations model. Keep watching Microsoft Mechanics for the latest updates. Thanks for watching. Bye for now.